If you are suffering from dry eyes and haven't found relief with existing treatments, there's exciting news on the horizon. In this video, I'll break down the top 5 new approaches for dry eyes. These are the ones most likely to become available soon. Dry eyes impact nearly 20% of the US population, costing over $55 billion every year in lost productivity and healthcare expenses. Options have evolved rapidly in just the past 3 years. I've covered this in my previous videos, but despite all these advancements, there are still millions of people who struggle to find treatments that are both effective and easy to use. If you or someone you know is in that group, I have some great news. The next wave of treatments looks incredibly promising. Stick around until the end, because after the 5 innovative approaches, as a bonus, I will talk about the one treatment that is already available now and in my experience has been a game changer for dry eye patients. Let's start with the first breakthrough on the horizon, gene therapy. This approach is revolutionizing how we think about dry eye treatment. Instead of just managing the symptoms, gene therapy aims to fix the problem at its very core. Scientists are exploring how to modify the very genes responsible for tear production and inflammation, offering hope for long-lasting relief. Think about it. One single treatment could restore your body's natural ability to produce tears and heal the eye's surface. For those whose dry eyes are caused by autoimmune diseases, a gene therapy could potentially rewrite the future, targeting specific genes to stop the disease. It might sound like science fiction, but it's quickly becoming real. In recent lab studies, scientists have modified the genes in mice to boost tear production and reduce eye damage. Another experiment targeted genes that cause inflammation, lowering the risk of further harm. But how does this actually work? The modified genes are delivered into the body using a harmless virus. This virus enters the eye cells, specifically targeting those responsible for tear production. Once inside, it adds new genetic instructions to the cell's DNA, helping it produce the right proteins or reduce inflammation. The body treats the virus like any other infection, but instead of causing harm, it helps the eye heal and function properly. While still being tested, the early results are very promising. If successful, gene therapy could completely change how we treat dry eyes. While gene therapy focuses on fixing the genetic of dry eye disease, stem cell therapy offers another groundbreaking approach. Stem cells can regenerate damaged tissue in the eye. Imagine being able to repair the eye and restore normal function using your own body cells. Stem cell therapy works by harnessing the power of stem cells, which are essentially the building blocks of our bodies. These cells have the unique ability to transform into any type of tissue needed for repair. In the case of dry eye, stem cells are injected into the surface of the eye where they help regenerate damaged tissue, such as the cornea or tear-producing glands. One of the most exciting parts of this research is potential to treat severe cases of dry eyes, especially those caused by diseases like rheumatoid arthritis or chemical burns. In fact, early clinical trials have shown that stem cells can restore normal tear production and reduce symptoms dramatically. Patients who were once reliant on constant eye drops and treatments are now reporting long-term improvement in their comfort and vision. The future of stem cell therapy is still unfolding, but the idea of regenerating the eye's damaged tissues brings hope to those who thought relief was impossible. Now, what if the secret to treating dry eyes wasn't just in your eyes, but in your gut too? It might sound strange, but new research is showing that the health of your gut is connected to the health of your eyes. Scientists call this the gut-eye axis. How does it work? Your gut is home to trillions of tiny bacteria that make up something called your microbiome. These bacteria help control inflammation in your body, including in your eyes. When the bacteria in your gut are out of balance, it can cause more inflammation, which can make dry eye symptoms worse. This discovery is opening up new ways to treat dry eyes. Studies have shown that improving your gut health with probiotics or changes in diet can reduce dry eye symptoms and help with tear production. Even though this research is still new, the gut-eye connection could be a big breakthrough in how we treat dry eyes in the future. The fourth innovation is about improving current eye drops. Imagine if instead of using eye drops several times a day, you only needed one treatment that could last for weeks or even months. Right now, treatments like artificial tears and anti-inflammatory drops can help, but they have to be used very often, which can be annoying and may not always work as well as they should. That's where advanced drug delivery systems come in, making life easier and more effective for people with dry eyes. The researchers are working on new ways to make these treatments better using advanced technologies like nanotechnology and slow-release systems. For example, imagine a tiny implant in the eye that slowly releases medicine over time, keeping your eyes hydrated and free of inflammation for months. These new systems deliver medication exactly where it's needed, cutting down on side effects and improving results. One exciting system in trials uses nanoparticles to deliver dexamethasone, a powerful anti-inflammatory drug, directly to the eye's surface. This drug is released slowly, providing relief for several weeks after just one treatment. This is a big step forward, and as these technologies continue to improve, the future of dry eye treatment will be much more convenient and effective. The last innovation we'll talk about is the use of biologic agents, special drugs that target specific parts of the body's immune system. These biologics are already being used to treat diseases like rheumatoid arthritis and psoriasis, and now they're being studied for eye care. They are very focused in how they work. Instead of just treating the surface symptoms of dry eyes, they go straight to the root of the problem, calming the immune system and preventing damage. If these drugs continue to show good results, they could become a key tool in treating chronic dry eyes, especially for people with serious cases. And now to the bonus that I promised, a treatment that is already available and has been an absolute game changer for many dry eye patients in our offices. The name of the treatment is IPL, standing for intense pulsed light. In our offices, IPL therapy has been a game changer for many of our dry eye patients, especially those with meibomian gland dysfunction. IPL was originally developed for dermatology, but it has shown great results in reducing inflammation and improving the function of oil-producing glands in the eyelids. By helping these glands work properly, IPL keeps the tear film stable and prevents quick evaporation. Many of our patients have experienced a significant relief after IPL treatment, with a noticeable decrease in symptoms and less reliance on artificial tears. It's been a highly effective tool in our practice. As you can see, the future of dry eye treatment is brighter than ever. From cutting-edge gene therapy that targets the root causes, to stem cell treatments that regenerate damaged tissues, and even advanced drug delivery systems that make daily eye drops a thing of the past. These innovations are changing how we think about treating this chronic condition. Meibomian gland dysfunction and blepharitis often accompany dry eyes and exacerbate the condition. Most patients with dry eyes can see great improvement in their condition if they treat their blepharitis. Click here to learn more about blepharitis and meibomian gland dysfunction. If you find value in this video, click the like button or subscribe for more videos like this.